This example looks at vapor-liquid equilibrium at constant pressure, where we have piston and cylinder arrangement, and we have liquid water, and we have water vapor in equilibrium at 1.2 bar. And then what we're going to do is inject into the vapor phase 5 cubic centimeters of air. We're going to keep the pressure constant because we have a constant weight on the piston, and we have this in a constant temperature bath. And the question is, when we get back to equilibrium after injecting the air, what has happened? Has all of the liquid vaporized? Has all of the water vapor condensed? Or is some of the liquid vaporized? Or is some of the water vapor condensed? First, we have to look at what assumptions we make for this system. First, we assume the pressure is low enough that we can assume ideal gases. And then we're going to assume the solubility of air in the liquid phase, water, is negligible. We're off at 1.2 bar for liquid water. The temperature is above 100 degrees C, and so the solubility is going to be pretty low at this elevated temperature. And then we ask ourselves the question, what happens? What does the air change about the system to determine the behavior and predict what the behavior will be? Let's look at the liquid water. Temperature is constant. The air does not dissolve in the water, so we haven't made any changes in the water. So we can say the fugacity of water in the liquid phase is constant for this system. It's not changing as we inject the air. Water vapor, however, is different. The total pressure is 1.2 bar. We only have water vapor present. And so that means that the pressure of water in the vapor phase initially is equal to the saturation pressure of water. And the saturation pressure of water is 1.2 bar. At a later time, the total pressure is constant, 1.2 bar. It's going to be equal to the pressure of the water plus the pressure of the air. So the air must have some partial pressure. And so once we've injected the air, then the pressure to water is less than 1.2 bar, which means the pressure of the water is less than the saturation pressure of the water. Or in terms of fugacities, the fugacity of water in the vapor phase is less than the fugacity of water in the liquid phase because we did not change the fugacity of water in the liquid phase. Fugacity of water in the liquid phase is going to be about the same as its saturation pressure, 1.2 bar. And so we have a difference in fugacity. And fugacity, or chemical potential, it's a driving force for mass transfer. So what this says is they're going to have liquid water is going to go into the vapor phase to try and get back to equilibrium. It's a non-equilibrium situation when the fugacity of water in the vapor phase is less than the fugacity of water in the liquid phase. We no longer have vapor-liquid equilibrium. Water is going to evaporate. As water evaporates, then the partial pressure of water increases. But, and this is the important aspect, partial pressure of water is always going to be less than 1.2 bar, which means the fugacity of water in the vapor phase is always going to be less than 1.2 bar. The fugacity is less than 1.2 bar. It says we can't have liquid in equilibrium with it at this temperature. Temperature is fixed. So all the water will evaporate. This would have to be a very large piston and cylinder because the water vapor occupies quite a bit more volume than the liquid water. So this would have to extend up dramatically in order to not just have the piston come out of the cylinder arrangement. And also we'd have to add heat to the system to vaporize this water. So we have it in a constant temperature bath. It means to get the equilibrium continuously adding heat to maintain that constant temperature to supply the heat of vaporization. Therefore, the answer is that all of the liquid evaporates to get back to equilibrium because of this difference in fugacity. An important point here is that it's a constant pressure system.